In a statement, President Yoweri Museveni highlighted a number of similar attacks that have terrorized the country. He said the four behind the attack in Kamwenge are the remnants of the Njovu Kamusu group of 10 that entered Uganda from Congo in the second round some weeks ago. He further noted that the group that killed the children of Nyabugando School, killed the two tourists and their driver, and also burned the onion truck is under the same group. The president noted that two of them were killed in the waters of Lake Edward by the Marines, and their leader Njovu was injured, captured, and is now facing charges in court. President Museveni further highlighted about a week ago that the CMI and the SFC commandos destroyed a squad of three of the group, including Kamusu, that had replaced Njovu as the group leader. Kamusu was shot, although they have not discovered his dead body yet. On account of these repeated atrocities by these infiltrators from Congo, the president has directed the UPDF to reactivate the force of the LDUs in the areas surrounding Queen Elizabeth National Park, Chibale Forests, the forest in Chenjojo and Kagadi, Semliki National Park, and Bwindi National Park. Relatedly, residents from Ketuhirira Village, Chabandara Parish in Kamwenge Sub-County, in Kamwenge District, have started escaping from their ancestral homes following the Mandi attack from the Allied Democratic Forces that left 10 people murdered. The Mandi killings have really scared us, and we are forced to flee our homes. We only returned to bury the counselor. ADF rebels who attacked might return and attack again. We are scared because we haven't seen an upgrade in the security at the moment.
We call upon the government to give us enough security for our families and our place in Chawanda.
The deceased from the Mandi attack include Esther Tushemerere, Chomhanji Mary, Ahumuza Princess, Kugonza Rosette, Banyanzaki Margaret, Knight Margaret was a counselor, among others. Leaders have condemned the act of ADF and appealed to the community to stop abandoning their homes, saying the situation will be contained by security agencies.
We are very grateful that UPDF and the security organs have come in to support, beef up the security within the area. I'm calling upon our people to go back to their homes and work. I believe now the situation is at control.
Relatedly, the Deputy Inspector General of Police, Major General Geoffrey Tumusime Katsigazi, has briefed the media about the ADF attack, condemning the gruesome murders.
I'm here mainly to come to meet our security agencies after the attacks of ADF in the areas of Kamwenge. So essentially we are coming here to assist the security situation, look at how they are positioned, and how best we can make it more robust so that we deny these terrorists freedom of action.
Story compiled by Anthony Antwini and Rogers Sunday for the news.